These faggots should get their own category.
There is no other word to describe this woman than weird. If I showed you that with no context, you would think, oh, it's a parody of how crazy MAGA Republicans are. And then you realize, oh no, this is a real person running for a job in politics. I have to be honest. I absolutely love election year. I love it. I love it. And I love it because, as I stated so many times on this podcast, that every 4 years, people who aren't aware of politics usually become hyper aware of it for 6 months. And not only that, but it becomes a part of the cultural zeitgeist. Because we're all hyper aware of what's happening and who we should and shouldn't vote for, and policies are being thrown left and right, we become more aware of the politicians who exist on the fringes of society. People that are outcasts within our own party, we find out about. And that's what happened this week on Twitter with a person who's running for Secretary of State in Missouri. Her name is Valentina Gomez. She got a banger. She was banger hunt. Yo, the politicians are banger hunt on the timeline. And here's what she posted.
These to get their own category, because before, if a man hit a woman, it used to land him in jail. Now it gets you a gold medal at the Olympics.
Stop right there. That's all you need to know about this. This video is 27 seconds long, and 10 seconds she's clearly stated a policy. Here's what I love about this new era of Trump inspired Republicans is that they used to dog whistle, right? They used to, like, you know, say things to rally their base up. Proud Boys, stand back and stand, shit like that. They used to just, like, speak in code. These new niggas just say it out loud. But that's because Trump has changed the culture around them. Now, this lady is somebody who is MAGA and is just on the fringes of Republican politics. Like, most sane Republicans aren't fuck. Even the ones that fuck with Trump are like, you can't just say the words. Like, we still want to be seen as human. But she just straight up says it. My favorite thing about this woman is she got bangers, though. Like, she got bangers on top of bangers. Like, her sauce is just like, I'm putting out a video all the time. She put out a video during Pride Month. I would like to play for the squad.
The weak and gay agenda is about to be shoved down our throats for the next month. Why don't we have a month celebrating American nationalism? Or
come on.
Family month.
Come
all
on.
The mothers and fathers out there that have fought for their children.
Vibes.
All the pussies out there like Don Lemon.
This bitch is opposed to pussy month. She said that shit with a straight face. She's not doing a bit, y'all. Like, she is dead ass. Like, yo, fuck this gay month. Pussy month. Y'all not understand what I'm saying? Like, do y'all really love pussy or not? If you don't, you're fucking gay. That's what she said. She said, do you love pussy, yes or no? Huh? Gay boy? Huh? You fucking gay boy? Also, I don't know what's her obsession with Straight Outta Compton. I don't know why. There's so many. I got a couple videos I want to show y'all. There's so many videos that she posts, because she posts a lot. Like, she is constantly banger hunting. I haven't checked her Instagram yet because I saw her on Twitter. But if I go look on, I'm gonna just look at her Twitter. How many video posts she has on her Twitter account? Can I check that real fast? Just on her Twitter account, she has almost 1,200 videos and pictures. Like, she pumping out content. She pumping them out. I don't know why Straight Outta Compton is her background track to so many of these videos, because I don't think that Ice Cube will fuck with that. Like, I'm not sure where Ice Cube politics lies. I'll be honest with you. I haven't checked up on Unk. I don't really know what his politics are and where they lie, but I can almost guarantee they do not lie with her. I can almost guarantee that they exist on opposite ends of the spectrum of what they think the future of politics should be and sound like. But for some reason, Straight Outta Compton is still the background track to her videos. She often just puts like the most hyped songs behind her. Like, she got this one where it's just the song. It's that Lil Wayne song from Ballers. And yes, to me, it's just a Lil Wayne song from Ballers. I don't know it as anything else. And if you know it as anything else, you're kind of weird.
We are not the same. You can put the weight of the nation on my shoulders and I won't feel anything. I need you to show up on August 6th. Let's save America.
Tell me you're not hyped. Tell me you're not sprinting to the polls. Tell me you don't watch this video and be like, she should be my Secretary of State. Like, this is the person I want. I don't know what the Secretary of State does. I have to be honest. I have no idea what the Secretary of State does, but I'm like, tell me this is not the person you want to represent you as the Secretary of State. Like, tell me this isn't everything you want in a candidate. I'm not going to lie. This woman is like, she's a fucking sicko, but besides her being a sicko, she might have the best content mind I've ever seen in my life. Like, if she wasn't like a raging homophobe and like running for a spot inside politics, I'll be like, nah, this person's kind of a vibe. But she just posts hella videos. Like, I'm here another one.
I am at the speaker's balcony and they don't like me here and neither in Jefferson City, but I don't give a fuck. I speak the truth.
She thought she would. I don't give a fuck. I'm at the speaker balcony. They do not like me here, but I don't give a fuck. I want to kill these pedophiles.
Good. Catch pedophiles and I will be Missouri's
44th. I want to kiss the pedophile and be Missouri's 41st Secretary of State. They don't like me here and I don't give a fuck. You don't like me here. Oh no. I gotta be guns. I gotta be going and I ride around Missouri with my be going. And I look around, can't try to catch the pedophile. Where the pedophile and the groomer? They show me pedophile and groomer in Missouri. We had to clean it all. We gotta clean it all. Or the gay boy. He's a gay boy. That's what I... Oh my God. I have to be honest with you. I've watched like 40 of her videos. I watched like 40 of them. Here's what I can tell you about her. Number one, she doesn't give a fuck. Number one. Most importantly, she don't give a fuck. Number one. Number two, she is really concerned about pedophiles and groomers. Wait a second. You see, I'm trying to figure out what happened. Is that the one record where she said she got molested? I'm trying to figure out, like, what's her sauce with pedophiles and groomers, and why is that something she so vehemently against? I'm not saying, like, she shouldn't be against pedophiles and groomers, because I think we all should. But I don't... I think it's bigger issues. Like, I'm not minimizing the pedophile and the grooming problem. I just don't know if that's, like, a winning campaign. I'm not sure if that's going to get it done, even in Missouri. I don't know. I don't know what the pedophile population inside Missouri is, but it can't be that large, right? It can't. The first thing is, I don't give a fuck. Number two, the pedophile, any groomer. And number three, just guns. She posts so many pictures of her with big ass guns. Sauce. It's sauce. Valentina Gomez is literally... I thought J.D. Vance... Like, you know what's funny? We talked about it on this podcast before, but I'll say it again. Like, finally the Democrats have just said the thing that we've all thought about most Republicans, especially MAGA Republicans, over the last... What is it? Since 2016? It's like, y'all are weird. And the fact that it's out in the zeitgeist now, we all just are saying it, is perfect, because there is no other word to describe this woman than weird. There's no other way to look at her besides for say, oh, you're fucking weird. You're a fucking weirdo. You're a fucking weirdo, and I don't get it. And I don't understand how anybody gets this thing or why anybody would vote for you. But people, I'm sure she will get votes. I think she has, what, 53,000 followers on Twitter. I'm sure she has more on Instagram. I lied, 200,000 on Twitter. That number went up recently. This Twitter account was made August 2023. So this running for Secretary of State shit is some new shit. I think she only 25 years old too. Like, she's young. Like, this is a Gen Z Trump inspired Republican at 25. Like, she wasn't even of legal age to vote the first time Trump ran. You understand what I'm saying right now? Like, I'm 20, I'd be 27. So, and that was my first election that year. That was my first election. I'm assuming that she was born 98. She wasn't even allowed to vote in the first election, but somehow she's been radicalized and she's full on, not just Republican, it's MAGA. MAGA has become its own party, its own subsect within the Republican Party. And it houses people like Valentina Gomez. I give a fuck about the pedophile. I give a fuck.
I have stood up to pedophiles, groomers, and corrupt politicians.
I stood up to pedophile, groomer, and corrupt politician.
But this hasn't come without a price.
But it hasn't come without a price.
They have tried to kill my father.
They tried to kill my father. By the way, Republicans love doing this. This is their sauce. Just make up shit. Just make up shit. J.D. Vance did the same thing. He was like, yo, this migrant shit really fucking up my family, because, like, my mom, she was addicted to the drugs they was bringing through the border. They from Ohio. Them drugs stop making it to Ohio, nigga. And he's been talking about some, my dad, yo, these goddamn politicians, I killed my dad. I don't believe that for a second, yo. I don't know what's happened in Missouri. I ain't gonna lie, maybe, because Ozark took place in Missouri. And Ozark, to me, is based off a true story. So maybe.
Poison my dogs. And
this. I gotta hear all this again.
But this hasn't come without a price. They have tried to kill my father, poison my dogs, and destroy me.
Hold on. I feel like those things lost importance as she went down the list. Like, she came out strong. They try to kill my dad. All right, that's crazy. They try to poison my dog. All right, hold on. Oh, poison it. What they did? Feed him grapes? Like, what the fuck happened? And then destroy me. Just vague as shit. Just destroy me. Like, I feel like those things stop. Like, we got to get. She got to get better at listing shit. That's just an awful list from a list perspective.
But I'm still standing because I have God and the American people by my side. I don't ask for money. I'd rather you go buy food and bullets for your family.
Oh, shit. Oh, fuck. I'm not asking you for money. I want you to use that money to go buy food and bullets. The two things that all humans need to survive. Ammunition and cheeseburgers. That's all we need. That's all Americans need. It's ammunition and cheeseburgers. This bitch is a cartoon character. It don't get funnier than this.
I simply ask you to come out and vote for me on August 6th. So fuck these gay pedophiles in our government.
Yo, funny gay pedophile. Funny gay pedophile. The gay pedophile fucking me, not covering me. Shit, so stupid. Oh, fuck. Oh, shit. Y'all, she's dead at. She not doing a bit, yo. Oh, fuck. This shit's so stupid.
Let's save America.
She loves Straight Outta Compton. That's just her. Every single video is Straight Outta Compton. I don't know, y'all. for the gay pedophile. The gay pedophile, they're trying to take our country. Oh my God. I love her. I love her. I love her. I'm not gonna here's why the Republican Party, especially like the MAGA sect of the party, they get so many people because they're just fucking hilarious. Like, objectively speaking, that is pure comedy. Like, if I showed you that with no context, you would think, oh, this person is doing a bit. Like, it's a parody of how crazy MAGA Republicans are. That's what you would think. That you would think, oh, that's funny. Like, that's, she took it there, but that's funny still. And then you realize, oh no, this is a real person running for a job in politics.
Well, hello, potty mouth.